Hi, my name is Dr. Head and I'm an anesthesiologist. Today in this video, I'd like to show you a technique for intubation using the GlideScope BFlex 5.0 millimeter scope, the GlideScope video laryngoscope, and the GlideScope Core 15 monitor. The techniques in this video are mine. Please consult your operations and maintenance manual prior to using this product. This intubation modality is very helpful for anticipated and unanticipated difficult airways. I'll be using a size 3 laryngoscope blade, so I'm going to go ahead and remove from the package and connect to the Core 15 monitor using the smart cable. Now I'm going to prepare the 5.0 millimeter outer diameter BFlex scope. You'll also need to remove the two protective sheaths. Before placing an endotracheal tube on the BFlex, you're going to want to lubricate the insertion tube. You also want to make sure that you keep the insertion tube in a neutral position. I do this by not putting my thumb on the lever. I'm now able to easily load the endotracheal tube onto the BFlex, and I can attach it to this tube retainer. Extremely helpful in maintaining the tube in this position without needing any taping. Next, I'm going to connect the BFlex scope to the Core 15 monitor as well. The dual view mode is important because it allows us to visualize what we're doing in the airway from two different perspectives, the laryngoscope blade and the BFlex view. Now I'm ready to start the procedure and I'll need my assistant. To start, I'm going to go ahead and do laryngoscopy on my mannequin. I'm able to get a great view of the cords, but this is a mannequin. Oftentimes with difficult airways, we're not able to get this great of a view of the cords despite the laryngoscope blade. That's why this mode is so helpful. Now I'm going to come behind the GlideScope laryngoscope blade with the BFlex bronchoscope. Even if Lauren wasn't able to keep the view as nicely as she has been able to, the GlideScope's going to provide a path for me to get my BFlex in great position to view the cords. Using just small manipulation, I'm able to get into the trachea. And now I can visualize both on her screen and on my screen what position I'm in. I'm ready to offload the endotracheal tube into the trachea. And I can watch it safely pass through the cords on her laryngoscope. By pulling back on the BFlex, I'm able to see the position of the endotracheal tube in the trachea as well. Just a reminder to keep your thumb off the lever so that you keep the scope in neutral position while you slowly retract the BFlex. Now we can remove the laryngoscope blade as well. The patient's been successfully intubated.